Hi children, today we are going to solve some numericals from the topics what we have discussed already. So let us go for the first numerical here. Our first one is estimate the average drift velocity of conduction electrons in a copper wire of cross-sectional area 2.5 into 10 power minus 7 meters squared carrying a current of 2.7 ampere, okay, and the density of conduction electron is given as 9 into 10 power 28 per meter cube. Okay, I have already instructed you, once a problem is given, first you understand the problem, okay, then what are all the data given, first you have to highlight, you have to write first, okay. Don't directly go to the problem, you are solving the problem. First you write the data, that will give you some idea, okay. So, what are all the things given first? Shall we go for, what is that? A, the copper wire of cross-sectional area. So, cross-sectional area is given, therefore A is given. What is A? A that is equal to 2.5 into 10 power minus 7 meters squared. Here you are, why am I asking you to write the data given? Because sometimes the data won't be given in SI unit. Okay, so it is your duty. You have to convert everything in the proper form. So keep everything ready. Then you go to the formula. Okay, so that will be easy for you to substitute and solve. Okay, that will not be any problem. Any, what is that? If you are directly you are converting, okay, there may be some error, that is why, okay, just to avoid it, first you write everything. A that is equal to 2.5 into 10 power minus 7 meters squared, right? Then what else is given? Current. Well, current I that is equal to 2.7 ampere, right? And then density of conduction electron, what do you mean by number density is given? Number density of conduction electrons. Number density of electrons means how to represent n, correct? N. That is number of electrons, free electrons per unit volume. That is number density. Therefore, that is given by 9 into 10 power 28 per meter cube per unit volume. Okay, right, everything is given. Now you are asked to find out what? Estimate the average drift velocity. Very simple. Then all these, what is the, in this, you know what is I, A, I and N. Therefore, you are asked for what is the drift velocity. Therefore, I think it is very, very simple. What is that? I, you know, I that is equal to N, E, A, V, T. So all are related, na? So here, what is asked here? What is asked here is drift velocity. That also you write. Vd that is equal to what? Okay. Therefore, now how to solve I that is equal to NaVd? It is a direct problem. Okay. Therefore, what is Vd? Vd that is equal to I divided by Nea. I divided by Ne. A. Therefore, everything is given. It is just okay. Therefore, that is what is that? 2.7 divided by what is n? N is 9 into 10 power 28. Then you know what is E? E that is equal to 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 charge of electron. Okay, into what else is given? Area. Area that is equal to 2.5 into 10 power minus 7. Hope you're following. Okay, therefore it is 2.5 into 10 power minus 7. Okay, therefore I is 2.7 and I think everything is correct. 2.7, 9 into 10 power 28. Okay, 1.6 into 10 power minus 2.5 into 10 power minus 7 is area. Therefore, that gives you, if you have to solve, okay, I'll give you the answer. On solving, you will be getting an answer that is 0.75 millimeter per second. Millimeter per second. Or you can even say, okay, 2.5 millimeter. Give the answer only in SI unit. Therefore, 0.75 into 0.75 into 10 power minus 3 meter per second. Are you following? 0.75 into 10 power minus 3 meter per second. That's it. Very simple, na? It is direct substitution. Okay, nothing other than that. Right. Therefore, next one. Next one, shall we go to the next problem? Okay. Therefore, see. The number you are given. See, next problem is the number of free electrons per 100 millimeter of copper wire is 2 into 10 power 21. Okay. Then the average drift velocity of electron is, drift velocity is given, 0.25 millimeter per second. Therefore, what is the current that is flowing? Okay, therefore, now what is given here? See, the length of the wire, the number of free electrons per 100 millimeter of copper wire is given. Therefore, you are given, the number of free electrons per 100 millimeter of copper wire. Therefore, you know that it is nothing. But therefore, but what we want here is, okay, therefore, and what else is given? VD is given, right? Everything. Okay. Therefore, here L is equal to 100 millimeter. Okay. Therefore, the number of free electrons per 100 millimeter of copper wire is given. Okay. Therefore, now you have to find out what is number density. Therefore, number is N. What is number density? Number density that is equal to number of electrons per unit volume. Okay. Therefore, L is the length. Okay. And let us assume that N, A is the area of the wire. A is the area of the wire. Area means area of cross section. Okay. Area of cross section of the wire. Okay, that we will assume, right? Okay, then VD is also given. What is here? VD that is equal to 0.25 millimeter per second. And what is asked is current. Okay, therefore, now, see, now what is, you know the very well that what is I that is equal to, once again, I that is equal to NEAVD. I that is equal to NEAVD. Fine. Right. But now we have to find out number of free electrons per 100 millimeter of copper wire is given. Therefore, what is N therefore here? You have to find out what is N here. N that is equal to number density. Okay. Number density of electron that is equal to 2. Okay. Into 10 power 21. Okay. Divided by unit volume. Now, what is one unit volume? It is number density. What is it? Number of electrons per unit volume. N. N is number of electrons per unit volume. Therefore, here, what? How many number of electrons? 2 into 10 power 21. Per unit volume, na? Volume, what is that? A into L. Correct? A into L. Hope you are following. Therefore, that is equal to, therefore, N that is equal to 2 into 10 power 21 divided by A. You don't know. Okay? A is the, we have assumed that A is the area of, okay? Have the cross section into, but L is given as, what is L? L is equal to 100 millimeter, it is given. Therefore, that is nothing but 100 into 10 power minus 3. See, here itself, you are supposed to, as I think I told you, this is method, what is the millimeter may given now? Immediately, what you have to do? That is equal to 100 into 10 power minus 3 meter. Okay, therefore it is 100 into 10 power minus 3, right? Therefore, now substitute here, therefore your I that is equal, you are asked for N is ready now, okay? And all the other things, VD is given. You have idea about what is that? Electronic charge. Therefore, what is, you are asked for I only, na? Therefore, what is I? I that is equal to N. In the place of N, it is, what is that? 2 into 10 power 21 divided by, okay, A into 100 into 10 power minus 3. It is, everything is N. Okay, then E. E is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19. Okay, then E is over. Then A into VD. VD, what is VD? VD is equal to 0.25 millimeter per second. Once again, we should have substituted. What is a millimeter per second? Ko to meter per second karna hai na? Immediately. Okay, see. That is why. That is equal to. See here. I that is equal. That is equal to. Here. 0.25 into 10 power minus 3 meter per second. Therefore, substitute here. That is equal to VD is. 0.25 into 10 power minus 3, okay, into A, this is N, okay, and this is your charge, and this is VD, and this is A, right, therefore, A and A will get cancelled, there is no A is not given in the data, therefore, what are all the things given, I, therefore, that is equal to, if you solve this, your I, are you following? I that is equal to 0.8 amps. Okay. So, yeah, I that is equal to 0.8 amps. So, this is the answer. But you people have to solve and see. Therefore, I that is equal. Hope you are following. This is also a direct question only. See, once again, L is given. Millimeter converted into meter. And N here you have to find out because number density, see, number of free electrons per 100 millimeter is given. Therefore, what is number of free electrons per unit volume? You have to find out. Therefore, what is an into 2 into 10 power 21 divided by A into L. So, L is given, right. Then VD is also given, but it is given in millimeter per second. Immediately you convert it to meter per second. Therefore, on substituting, direct substitution only, I is equal to NEA VD. Therefore, on substituting, you will be getting the answer. It is, the answer, final answer is, what is that? I that is equal to 0.8 amps. Okay, right. Then next one. What is the next one? Let's see. What is the drift velocity of the electron, okay, in a conductor, what is the drift velocity for the electron in a conductor when an electric field of strength 200 volt per meter is applied on it and the mobility of the electron is 4.5 into 10 power minus 6 meters squared per volt second, okay. So, what is, first, therefore, what is the drift velocity of the electron in the conductor when the electric field is strength? Therefore, electric field is given. Okay. Therefore, what is E? E is given. Therefore, what is E? E that is equal to, E is equal to, what is the 200, okay, volt per meter or Newton per coulomb. Right. Then, next one, what is that? The mobility. Mu. What is mu? Mu that is equal to 4.5 into 10 power minus 6 meters squared per volt second. Right. Then you are, what is asked? You are asked for drift velocity. Therefore, what is VD that is equal to volt. That's it. Therefore, how to find? It is direct question actually. Okay. How all these three are related? Okay, mobility. Mobility that is equal to, you know, mobility is nothing but, okay, mu is nothing but drift velocity per unit electric field. Drift velocity per unit electric field. Correct? Therefore, you will get what is, what is drift velocity? Therefore, VD that is equal to mu into E. Mu into E. Substitute. That's it. Therefore, that is equal to 4.5 into 10 power minus 6, okay, into 200. Therefore, you will be getting the answer as, therefore, on substituting, you will be getting that is nothing but 9 into 10 power minus 4 meter per second. Check the answer, you solve and check. Okay, VD that is equal to 9 into 10 power minus 4 meter per second. It is a direct question. Okay, just to recall the formulas. Okay, not a very difficult question. Okay, right. Next one. So, next one is, see, we will come to fourth question. Right, fourth question here. See, a wire of, very important question, see. A wire of 10 ohm resistance is stretched to thrice its original length. Okay, what will be its new resistivity and new resistance? Okay, therefore, what is its new resistivity and new resistance? Very simple. First, new resistivity. You know that, see, when the wire is nicely stretched, when it is stretched like that, what will happen? Its length will increase. Okay, stretching. You are stretching it. Okay, therefore length will increase and its, what is the area of cross-section, will become thinner. The area of cross-section will decrease. Right, fine. But now the question is, what will be the first part? If you see the first part, what will be its, what is that resistivity? See, here see, resistivity, you know very well, it depends only on two factors, recall it. It depends, number one is the nature of the material, nature of the conductor, okay? And number two, on temperature. It depends only on two factors. It is independent of, what is that, the dimensions, that is length, area, etc., etc. So here on stretching, the area changes and length changes, but the material will change? No. Therefore, what do you say here? The resistivity. Okay, therefore, the resistivity. Okay. Yes, what is that? Remains the same. Resistivity depends. Depends only on two factors. What is that? Nature of material. Nature of the material of the wire. Okay. Wire. And is independent of the dimension. Okay. And is independent of dimensions of the wire. Okay, that is area, length, etc., etc. Therefore, what is that? Resistivity remains unchanged. Correct? Okay, first part is over. That's all. It is independent. So, number two. What is that? What will happen to its new resistance? New resistance. Resistance depends on length, area, material, everything. Okay? Here, material is not changed. Temperature is not changed. Only what is changing here? What is changing? Length and area. Length is increased and area is decreased. Are you following? But how is the length? It is stretched to thrice. Stretched to thrice is length, right? Let the initial length is, what is that? L, initial length, and initial area is A. Okay? Therefore, see, and final length, after stretching, the final length is L dash, and this is A dash. Area is A dash after stretching, right? Okay, but in the, both the cases, before stretching and after stretching, if you see, one factor remains, the material is same, of course, right? But apart from that, what is actually unchanged here? What remains the same? That is the volume. Okay, so in both the cases, volume of the wire is same. Length is changed, area is changed, volume remains the same. Are you following? Therefore, now you know that, therefore, you just, I'm writing V that is equal to AL. Correct? And that is nothing but A dash L dash. A dash L dash. Are you following? But here it is given, see, the it is stretched to thrice x, stretched to thrice x original length. Therefore, you know that L dash, that is equal to 3L. Is equal to 3L. Are you following? Therefore, there are here it is very, very important. Usually, it is stretched to thrice its original length. It may be sometimes it is asked, no, it is increased by thrice of its original length. That is very, very important. Both are having some different meaning. See, it is stretched to means L dash is equal to 3 into L. Okay, and it is increased by thrice its original length. Increased by thrice its original length means that time L dash will be, if it is increased by, I am telling, not this problem, if it is asked. Okay, if it is increased by thrice its original length means it is L plus 3L ho jayega, usme to 4L ho jayega. Are you following? So the wordings is very important. Is stretched to means what is that? It is stretched to means it is direct. What is that? L dash, that is equal to stretched to thrice its original length. Therefore, L dash equal 3 into L. Are you following? Therefore, okay. Therefore, what will be your A dash number? Because you don't have idea, but length is given. But what is A dash? New area of cross section. Okay. Now, how to find out here A dash? That is equal to A L by L dash. Correct? A L by L dash. What is A L? This is nothing but A L divided by L dash is equal to 3L na? 3L. Therefore, what is that? Is A by 3. Therefore, you know that A dash here is decreased. Okay. How it is? 1/3 of its original area. Okay, 1/3 of its original area. So you have idea about the new length and new area. Are you following? Therefore, okay, what is the original resistance? Resistance is R. Okay, therefore original resistance R, that is equal to rho into L by A. R is equal to rho into L by A. Okay, and new resistance. New resistance. What is new resistance? R dash. That is equal to rho. Rho will not change, no? Into L dash by A dash. Are you following? Therefore, that is nothing but what is that? Rho into L dash, kya ho gaya? L dash is equal to 3L. Correct? And what is A dash? A dash is equal to A by 3. Fine? Therefore, what is your R dash therefore? Therefore, what is R dash? R dash is equal to, see, that is nothing but here. This is, what is that? This is nothing but, what is that? Rho. This 3 will come the here now. Upon 9 into rho L by A. 9 into rho L by A. Are you following? Okay. Therefore, that is nothing but 9 into R. 9 into R. Okay. Let me bring this here. Okay. That is here. Therefore, what is the R dash? From this, R dash, that is equal to, from here, see, rho into 3L by A by 3, now, therefore, R dash becomes, okay, rho L by A into 9, correct, into 9, that is nothing but original resistance, kya hota hai isme? R that is equal to, anyhow, R that is equal to, what is that, given, R that is equal to 10 ohms, isme diya hai. Therefore, what is that? 9 into 10, that is equal to 90 ohm. That is equal to 90 ohm. Are you following? Hope you are following. Okay. Because there is a, I have left a little space here. Anyhow, see, R is equal to rho L by A, initial resistance. Final resistance R dash is equal to rho L dash by A dash. How, yeah, what is the new length, the new resistance, everything you know. On substituting, you will be getting it is 90, what is that, ohms. It is the new resistance. Right. Next one. See, a wire has a resistance of 16 ohm. Okay. Okay. It is melted and drawn into a wire of half its length. Melt. It is melted, then it is made to a wire of half its initial length. Calculate the resistance of the new wire. Okay. What is the percentage change in its resistance? You are asked for percentage change in the resistance also. Okay. Here you see, you are asked for the percentage change in the resistance. Okay. Very good. Very simple. Now, shall we go over, see what is given? Initial resistance. What is the initial resistance R that is equal to? Kya hota hai? Say 16 ohms. Okay, very good. Okay, now see, it is melted and it is drawn. Therefore, let L, what is that? Let L, everything is a new, what is that? Initial length and initial area of cross section. And L dash, A dash are the new length and new area of cross section. And it is very clearly given. What is L dash? L dash, though, what is that? It is L dash that is equal to, it is half its original, therefore L by 2. L dash is L by 2 given. This is also given. Are you following? Therefore, once again, like the previous problem, which is constant here, volume remains constant. Therefore, you can say V that is equal to volume is equal to AL that is equal to A dash L dash. A dash L dash. Okay, you have to find out how the area changes, because what is that? It is melted and drawn into a wire of half its length. Half its length means definitely area will increase, na? Because its length has become less, therefore area has to increase. How much? What is the area? What is the increase in area that you have to find out? For that, once again you take the concept, the volume remains the same. Therefore, A L that is equal to A dash L dash. Correct. Therefore, once again, what is A dash? A dash that is equal to, what is it? A L by L dash. Correct. That is equal to A L L dash. Kya hota hai? L by 2. Therefore, what is your A dash? Is nothing but 2A. A dash is nothing but 2A. That is increased now. Length becomes half, means area becomes twice. Hope you are following. Okay. Now, so you have the new length, new area. New length is given already. New area is known. And you have to find out what is the new resistance. Okay. Therefore, how to find out? Therefore, new resistance, what is that? R dash. Okay, R dash that is equal to rho L dash by A dash. Correct? And that is nothing but rho. What is L dash? L by 2. Hana? And what is your A dash? A dash is nothing but 2A. Okay, therefore you will be getting here rho L by A, here 4 na, therefore rho L by A, 4A, rho L by 4A, are you following? Therefore, your R dash that is equal to 1 by 4 times rho L by A. Are you following? What is rho L by A? It is your initial resistance. Therefore, it is 1 by 4 into R. R is equal to rho L by A, na? Initial. Okay. That is nothing but, kya hai? R is equal to 16, hai na? Therefore, it is 16 by, what is that? 4. That is nothing but 4. Oops. Okay. Therefore, are you following? Okay. Therefore, this is your R by 4. Okay. Therefore, it is R dash is equal to 4 ohm. Therefore, you get R dash that is equal to 4 ohm. That is ready. Okay. What is the new resistance? What that is found? But you are asked for what is the percentage change in the resistance? Percentage change is nothing but, okay, percentage change in the resistance. Therefore, here, therefore, what is the percentage change? Percentage change. What is the change? Decrease here. Percentage decrease now. Why? Because your initial resistance is 16 ohm. Final resistance becomes 4 ohm. 4 ohm. That is a decrease in the resistance. Therefore, percentage change or percentage decrease in resistance. What is that? Decrease in the change in resistance divided by original resistance into 100. These things we have seen many times in error analysis and 11th standard. Many problems we have seen this one. Okay. Change in resistance divided by original resistance into 100. That gives you percentage change. Therefore, what is a change in resistance or a decrease in resistance? Here it is change is nothing but decrease. Why? Initial resistance 16, final resistance is 4. Okay. Therefore, I can write percentage change in resistance is nothing but formula kya hota hai? Change in resistance R minus R dash na. Okay. Divided by original resistance. Correct? Change in resistance divided by original resistance into 100. Into 100. Okay. And that is nothing but what is that initial 16? Final is 4 divided by initial is 60 into 100 into 100. Are you following? Therefore, I think this is nothing but 75% arena. Yeah, this is 75% change in resistance here. Percentage change in resistance is nothing but 75. Okay, hope you are following this. Okay, right. So next one, what is the next problem? Here. Okay, next is very simple. Find the resistivity of the conductor. In which the current density is given 2.5 ampere per meter squared is found to exist when electric field of 15 volt per meter is applied on it. Simple, direct problem. What is that? You see, what is given? Find the resistivity of the conductor in which the current density of 2.5. therefore, what is given is, okay, J, that is equal to current density is 2.5 ampere per meter squared is given, is found to exist when an electric field of what is it, 15 volt per meter. Therefore, E is also given, it is 15 volt per meter. So you are given with current density and electric field. What is asked? Resistivity. Therefore, rho, that is equal to what? Direct problem. Okay, everything is just to recall the formulas. Okay, so what is that? How J, E, rho are related? Okay, what I think J, that is equal to, recall sigma E na. J is equal to sigma into E. What is okay? And this is another, what is it? It is conductivity, and this is electric field. J, this current density is equal to conductivity into electric field. That is nothing but E by rho na. That is nothing but E by rho. Okay, that's it. That is enough for you now. Therefore, what is that? Rho, that is equal to, okay, E by J. E by J. Therefore, both are given. What is E? E is equal to 50. And what is rho? Rho, everything is SI unit. Yeah, that is 2.5. Okay. 2.5. Therefore, that is nothing but kya hai? It is nothing but 6 na. 6 ohm meter. 6 ohm meter. Okay. So this is a direct question. Okay. Right. Next we'll go to this 7th. Okay. 7th one. See, a wire carries a current of 0.5 5 amps when a potential difference of 1.5 volt is applied across it direct. Okay, what is its conductance? Fine, what is its conductance? Right, if the wire is of length 3 meter and area of cross section is 5.4 millimeter squared, calculate its conductivity. Okay, so first you write the data given. See, what are all the things given? You tell me for what is that? A wire carries a current of, therefore current is given I, that is equal to 0.5 amps. Fine. When a potential difference V, that is equal to 1.5 volt. Okay. Then what else is given? What is its conductance? What is its conductance means? How to G, that is equal to what? Conductance. Fine. And after that, if a wire is having a length L is equal to 3 meter and area of cross section, what is area of cross section? Area of cross section, that is equal to A, that is equal to area of cross section is what is the 5.4 millimeter square, therefore into 10 power minus 6 meter square. Okay, so these things are given and G is asked, and also you are asked for conductivity, sigma, that is equal to what? Conductivity is also asked. Okay, fine. So very simple, V is given, I is given. Okay, you know what is conductance. You are asked first part is conductance. Now what is G? Conductance is equal to 1 by R. Reciprocal, inverse of resistance is nothing but conductance. Correct? Like that, inverse of resistivity is conductivity. Okay, therefore G is equal to 1 by R. R, you can very very easily find out what is R, that is equal to okay, because I want to change the, what is your R, that is equal to V by I. Okay, V is given. What is V? V is 1.5 divided by 0.5. Therefore, it is 3 ohms. So, resistance is 3 ohms now. Therefore, what is your G? G, that is equal to 1 by 3. 1 by 3 means it is 0.33. Okay, ohm, here it is mo, or it is, I think I told you, siemen, right? Okay, then yes, okay, just like that, mo, or you can write that is, or it is, what is that? That is 0.33, yes, capital S, okay, everything you have seen, right? Next one, when the conductance is over, now what is that? Conductivity sigma, that is equal to 1 by resistivity. Okay, what is resistivity? Resistivity is equal to, what is it? R into A by L, therefore 1 by rho means it is L by R A, L by RA. Therefore, L, what is L? Length is 3 meter, na? 3. 3 divided by, what is your R? R, here it is given. 3, we have said 3, okay. R is 3 into, what is area? Area is 5.4 into 10 power minus 6. Okay, therefore, L is, I think I have substituted correctly. L here, length is 3, and here we have R, we have calculated R is equal to 3, therefore this one, right? Therefore, on substituting, okay, if you solve it, you will get the answer as 1.85 into 10 power 5, okay? What is the unit? Unit is more. Oh, it is ohm meter. It is mo per meter. Mo per meter. Or it is siemen per meter. Are you following more per meter? Or it is SIEMEN. I think this we have seen, right? So this is about, that's all. This is a problem that's directly is given. Okay, you have to substitute, the formula, that's all. For which you should have a very clear idea about what is that, all the formulas. Otherwise, it will be difficult. Okay, so next one. Next one is, see, this is, next topic is, see, we are going to see temperature coefficient of resistance with that. The resistance of the platinum wire at ice point is 5 ohm. Fine. Okay, and at steam point is 5.23 ohms. When the wire is inserted in a hot bath, then the resistance of the platinum wire that time is 5.795. Okay, calculate the temperature of the hot bath. Very simple. See, here you we have to find out what is that resistance. What are all things given first wheel, right? See, what is the resistance of the wire, platinum wire at ice point. Ice point means R naught at 0 degree Celsius, correct? That is equal to, what is that, 5 ohm given. Okay, then what else is given at the steam point? Therefore, R100 is also given. R100 is 5.23 ohm. Okay, fine. And when it is inserted in a hot bath, when the wire is inserted in a hot bath ka temperature you have to find out. Let the T be the temperature of the hot bath. What we have to find out. Are you following? Therefore, what about the resistance? When it is inserted in the hot bath of temperature, what is the T? Okay, its resistance becomes, what is the resistance? 5.795 ohm. Okay, therefore what is asked? Therefore what is your T? Okay, so all the resistance is given. Resistance R naught is given, R100 is given, RT is given, and you are asked for T. Okay, so how to find out here? You have to see, we have seen what is the temperature coefficient of resistance, na? So, what is the formula for temperature coefficient of resistance? R. See, the temperature coefficient of resistance. What is that? Alpha, na? Alpha, that is equal to, what is that? R2 minus change in resistance per original resistance per degree rise of temperature. Correct? So, first what I am going to take? See, I am going to take, okay, these two temperatures. R100 or R0. With respect to that, if I write alpha, alpha is equal to what is that? R2 minus R1. What is R2? R0 and R100 only. I am going to take with respect to that. If I want to express alpha, alpha is nothing but R100 minus R0. Okay, are you following? What is alpha? Alpha is equal to R2 minus R1 by R1 into T2 minus T1. Can you? It is increase in resistance per original resistance per degree rise of temperature. This we have already seen. Now here, if I take only R0 and R100, what is that, the ice point and steam point, with respect to that, how can I express the temperature coefficient of resistance? Alpha is equal to R100 minus R0 divided by R0, okay, into what is the temperature difference between ice point and this one? It is 100, correct? 100. Are you following? Okay, so this let it be equation number 1. Okay, now what am I'm going to do now is, I'm going to express same alpha but in the other pair. What is that? Now I am going to take the other pair as RT and R0. Okay, Therefore, with respect to that, I want to express alpha also. Alpha can be expressed in terms of the other pair. What is that? It is RT. RT is, what is that? RT and R not 1. It is not R100. I am going to express in terms of, sorry, it is not R100. I am going to express only in terms of RT and R not. RT and R not. That is, RT is R2, R not is R1. Okay. Therefore, what is that? It is RT minus R not theta divided by the original resistance is R not into what is the rise of temperature? Rise of temperature is nothing but T minus 0 na. T, it is here, it is 0 degree Celsius na. It is 100 degree Celsius, it is 0 degree Celsius. What is the temp? Here it is T degree Celsius. Okay, therefore, what is the difference? Difference here is nothing. T minus 0, that I can write at T. Okay, therefore, it is equation number 2. Okay, hope you are following, children. First, I am taking the pair, what is R naught, R100. And with respect to that, I am expressing alpha. Then after that, I am expressing alpha in terms of the other pair. What is that? RT and R0. RT and R0. Okay. Therefore, what is that? This is RT minus R0 divided by original resistance R0 into, what is that? Change in temperature. Rise of temperature here is T. Okay. So, both are same. Next, equate 1 and 2. Therefore, equating 1 and 2, you can say that, what is that? R100 minus R0 divided by R0 into 100. That is equal to RT minus R0 divided by R0 into T. Okay. Therefore, what is your T? Therefore, what is required here? Temperature one is required? No. Therefore, temperature of the hot bath. Okay, therefore T that is equal to RT minus R0 divided by R100 minus R0 na? R100 minus R0. Okay, this will go. Okay, R100 into 100. Into 100. Okay, therefore that is not, all the things are given here. What is your RT? RT is 5.795, R0 is 5 and R100 is 5.23, right? Therefore, what is RT? RT is 5.795 and R0 is 5. And what is R100? 5.23 minus 5. Into 100. Into 100. Okay. Therefore, you will be getting T as everything. See, 100 R not everything is, it is in Celsius only. No, we have taken everything here. 0 degree Celsius, 100 degree Celsius. Okay. Everything. Therefore, you will be getting temperature only in final temperature also in Celsius. If you, that is nothing but if you find 5.795 divided by 0.23 into 100, and if you solve, you will be getting around 345.65 degrees Celsius. Are you following? So this is the temperature of the hot bath. 345.65. It is the temperature of the hot bath. Are you following? Right. So this we have used. What is that? R0 resistance at different temperatures are known. Okay, and what you have to make use of temperature coefficient resistance formula. Okay, so how to, you should know how to use. See here, first pair and next pair for resistance is given, but the temperature is R. Therefore, anyhow, your temperature coefficient of resistance is the same. Therefore, for the given metal, it is the same, almost it will be the same. Therefore, equivalent, and you will find out the temperature. Then next one is, see, a potential difference V is applied to a conductor of length L, diameter D. How are the electric field E, the drift velocity Vd, and the resistance R affected when, okay, V is doubled, number 2, L is doubled, and number 3, D is doubled. Okay, very good. Okay, this is a CBC question, actually the board question. See, therefore, what is that? You are given, see, V, L, D, these are given, and you have to find out what is that? What will happen? And V is double, L is double, and D is doubled. Okay, therefore, first, what will happen when V is doubled? Okay, electric field. First, what is the electric field? What will happen to electric field? This one, right. Okay, so electric field E, that is equal to, okay, you know that it is V by L. V by L, correct? Therefore, you see, V by L. Therefore, what is your Vd? What is your Vd, drift velocity? Drift velocity, that is equal to, what is that? What is the formula? E by M into tau. That is equal to, what is that? E V. 1 second, children. Okay, so drift velocity here, it is E by M into tau, you have idea. Therefore, now I want everything in terms of, what is that? I want write in terms of V, L, and D. Okay, initial. Therefore, how to write E, capital E, that is nothing but electric field is V by L na. Therefore, I can write by this one as V by L is E, okay, into tau. First, I will write, because see, you are asked for what is that? Initial potential difference is given, length is given, diameter is given. Understand the question, okay? How the electric field E, drift velocity, and the resistance change, how are they affected, okay, when these factors, any one of the factor is changed, okay? So first one, for that first you write the all the three things, what is electric field, drift velocity, and resistance in terms of these three factors, if it depends. Okay, therefore, now what is the resistance now? Therefore, resistance R, that is equal to, you know that rho into this L, everything L should be the same, no? Capital L means it is given as capital L. So, don't change that one, it is capital L, V by L. Okay, and here it is rho into L by A. R is equal to rho into L by A. First, you write all these things, because you have how, what is that? The electric field, drift velocity, and the resistance are affected when some of the factors are changed. Okay, so first you write the formula. So, all the three things are ready. V by L is E, and E V by ML into tau, that is nothing, drift velocity, resistance equal rho L by A. Now, you go to the first case. What is the first case? V is doubled, affected when V is doubled. Okay, when V is doubled means, what will happen when V is doubled? E will become double, E will be doubled. Are you following? When? So, first one, when V is doubled. Okay, you can say electric field is nothing but V by L na. Therefore, V is double means E will also be doubled. E will be doubled. Fine. Okay, therefore it will become 2V by L. Correct? Huh? Right. Next one. What will happen to, VD, what is VD, drift velocity? Therefore, VD is equal to, VD also depends on V, na? EV by ML, EV by ML. Therefore, when V is doubled, VD will also be doubled. VD will also be doubled. Okay, right. Now third one. What will happen to the resistance now? Resistance equal to rho L by A only. Rho L by A. Okay, so it is independent of V. I think resistance is independent of V and I. Why? R is equal to V by I. So it is, our resistance is independent of what is that, current as well as the potential difference. Therefore, R remains the same. R remains the same. Is it clear? That is the first one. The next one is, because for that only keep the formulas ready so you can substitute. L is doubled. When L is doubled, when? Next one. When L is doubled, okay, what will happen to your E? Therefore, E, becomes half. Okay, so E will be halved. Correct? E by, why? E is equal to V by L. So, L becomes double means E will be, halved. Okay, right. Now, what will happen to drift velocity? Okay, so the drift velocity also will be halved only. Why? Drift velocity also? EV by ML. L becomes, if L is doubled, definitely VD will be halved. VD will be halved. Okay, right. Now, next one. What will happen to the resistance? Resistance here, R is equal to rho L by A. When L becomes, L is doubled, R will also be doubled. Therefore, R will be doubled. R will be doubled. Okay, right. Third one, it is third one. You see, what is the third one? What will happen when D is doubled? When D is doubled, see, it is, E is independent, you see, very important. See, E is independent of D. Correct? Like that, your drift velocity is also independent of your the thickness of the wire. Okay? Therefore, but only which depends, only here area of cross section, resistance only depends on it, right? Therefore, go back, therefore what will happen when D is doubled, E remains unchanged. VD remains unchanged. But what will happen to R? What will happen to R? R here. R will be, what is here? That is, if I want to write in terms of, what is a D? I think I can write rho L by pi r square, na? Pi r. R means what is a d by 2, correct? Therefore, d by 2 the whole square. It is d by 2 the whole square. Therefore, that is nothing but, what is that, 4? Okay? Rho L by pi d square. Hope it is, you are able to understand. It is very cluster like that. Anyhow, see, rho L by A. A here, pi r squared, na?
pi r, r I want only in terms of d, therefore d by 2 the whole square, therefore you will be getting 4 rho l by pi d squared. Therefore, what will happen to your resistance, okay, when d is doubled, when d is doubled, okay, therefore your resistance will be becomes, what is that, 1/4 na, okay, therefore R, okay, will be what is that, 1/4, it will be 1/4 of initial resistance, okay, because D will become, what is that, D becomes double means it is 2D the whole square, therefore it will be 4, okay, therefore 1 by 4 times the initial resistance, okay, therefore R will be 1 by 4th of the initial resistance, okay, right. So this is the next question. VI graph for the metallic wire at two different temperatures T1 and T2 is shown, right. Which of the two temperatures is higher? Okay, so which of the two temperatures, it is a metallic wire. Therefore, you know that the resistance of the wire, okay, R is directly proportional to temperature. Correct, for metallic wire, more the temperature, more will be R. Why? More will be collision, right? Already we have seen, right. Therefore, here it is given in along the x-axis is V and y-axis it is I. Therefore, first you have to find whichever is having, what is that, more resistance. Therefore, that will be that will be at higher temperature. Okay. Therefore, now you see here, I think I told you how to take and fix one. That is at x-axis V is there, now fix it. Therefore, that corresponds to here. This is for the first one, this is I1. Okay, and this is for the second one, T2 na, therefore that current is I2. But both corresponds to, what is that, same V. Are you following? Both corresponds to same V. Okay. Therefore, you can say from the graph, okay, what is R1 from here? R1 that is equal to V by I1. Okay. And what is R2? R2 that is equal to V by I2. V by I2. So, if you compare here, what is that? I1 here. Okay. Here you see. Here I1 is more than I2. In the graph, you see. I1 is more than I2. Okay. And therefore, I1 is more than I2 means, if you substitute, what will be R1? Therefore, R1 will be less than R2. Okay. Therefore, R1 will be less than R2. Therefore, R2 is having more resistance. R2 is having more resistance means definitely, what is that? V2. R2 is more having more resistance means definitely, therefore, T1 will be less than T2. T1 will be less than T2. Therefore, which is at higher temperature? Therefore, T2 is greater than T1. T2 is greater than T1. Is it clear, children? Okay, that's it.